Hi guys, Kay here from Y'all Hearing This with a super quick message for you. We are currently doing a giveaway. Once we hit 1,000 subscribers, 5 things will be up for grabs. Please see our pinned video on our page for more info. But do you guys want to win things like, the Vogue V covers that just came out? I have all 6. Or, we've got things like the Maxident, Stray Kids, Case File albums. I've got all 8. Or maybe you're a Maynard Monday fan, you want a signed bottle from Maynard's Vineyard. Or even just some merch from our shop on Redbubble. Anyway, all you have to do is hit subscribe. That's it. That's all. It's super easy. We hope you do it. Thank you for all your support as always, and I hope you enjoy the video. Hi guys, welcome back to Y'all Hearing This, Maynard Monday. I'm Kay. Thank you guys so much for coming back and joining us. So this week we are going to get into the Grudge by Tool. It was a request, I think, back on one of our first Maynard Monday videos. So sorry it took me so long to get to it, but I'm very excited to listen to it. As far as I know, I have never heard it before, but we will see. But one thing I did want to mention before we get going too much is we are doing a like road to 1K subscriber giveaway type of thing. So for once we hit 1,000 subscribers, we're going to be giving away 5 items. It'll be kind of first come, first serve. So whoever I choose first will pick first and then second, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And one of the things I'm going to be giving away is I got a bottle from Caduceus Wineries that is actually signed by Maynard, which is pretty cool. We're also going to be giving away some Stray Kids albums, some BTS V Vogue covers, and items from our Redbubble shop. So there's a video right on our page. You can see the whole thing. But basically, if you're subscribed, you have a chance to win. We're just doing a random drawing from our subscriber list. But anyway, we really appreciate all of your support. It has meant so much to us, and so we kind of wanted to give back as well as maybe make it like a fun thing and, hopefully get our stuff out there more. But anyway, let us get into The Grudge by Tool. I'm very excited. I'm always excited on Maynard Monday. Come on now. But yeah, let's watch. I've heard this before. I love that constant mix-up. You just have no idea what's gonna happen next.
Otherwise it all comes down, terrified of being alone, ultimate prison.
love the different percussion in this. It's really great. Is one of the best voices. I love how like soft and like kind of ethereal he can sound sometimes, and then he just gets that kind of screamy voice out. Wear a grudge like a crown. I like that line. That's super powerful. Gets late Mary when he's talking about letting things go. Band ever, really. This is so amazing.
Thank you.
Wow. That song felt like what holding a grudge feels like, you know? And when, especially that sustained like scream at the end is like when you just let all that anger and hatred out. Because holding a grudge is like, it's holding that inside your body, you know? And it's, well, A, it's not healthy, although believe me, I get it totally and have held many a grudge in my life. Wow, that was a super good song. That was so good. I have been sleeping on this goddamn pants, this album, this everything. I'm so happy I've been doing these. Thank you guys so much for the suggestion because that was amazing. Amazing. It's going on all my playlists right now. But yeah, anyway, let's get into it a little bit. So I'm getting this off of Genius. Let's see. Do-do-do-do. All right. So it's a song about maturity and development using alchemical, astrological, and mythological symbolism. That's cool. I wasn't really listening to the lyrics like that closely, but I did think I caught Saturn anyway. So the planet Saturn has an orbital period of 29 and a half years. So it returns to the astral position it occupied at the time of an individual's birth, as that individual approaches age 30. That's really cool, actually, because. Yeah, I could definitely say like when I hit about 30, there are some big changes for sure. Jungian psychology, which is based mostly on alchemy, similarly defines the transit as a period of transition to maturity into adulthood. This may manifest itself as professional success, which, by the way, if you don't hit professional success by 30, I didn't really hit it until a couple of years ago, and I'm 42. So, you know, you're gonna be okay. Get through it. Your 30s are better than your 20s. Your 20s are for damn sure better than your teen years. But 40s so far, really cool. Establishing a family or the fulfillment of other responsibilities, but it could also be a time of struggle and strife if the individual going through the transit cannot approach the period with the right mindset, letting go of our need to control and hold on to the life we know. Boy, ain't that the truth. The Grudge portrays an example of the latter, an individual struggling to move on from past wrongs and unable to transcend or grow up as a result. By the end of the song, the answer is very clear with the repeated injunction to let go. So true. Tool often incorporates lyrical themes into the music composition itself. In this case, the unusual 5/8 time signature divides the Grudge into units of 10 beats, 2 bars per line, echoing the significance of the number 10 in lyrics. A total absence of tempo changes strengthens the effect, although Danny Carey camouflages what might otherwise be a rigid formula with some ingenious drumming. I mean, he's the best. The downbeat stresses change between different sections, for example, 3/3/4 during the chorus and 5/5 during the let go outro. This alters the pulse and creates contrast between different parts of the song. I mean, absolutely. And this was off of Lateralis from 2001. I can see all of that. I definitely want to go back and listen more to the lyrics now too, but I mean, Jesus, they're so good. I love everything about it because like I've said in past videos, I really love like the intention behind songs too, you know? And to think that much about what you're doing, not only lyrically, but like musically, I think just makes the band so good. And it for just to be like an amazing song, you know, because I think you can think too much about things sometimes too and make it be more almost clinical, you know, but for whatever reason, there's like this magic formula with them that just works. But anyway, I loved this song, as you can probably tell. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you like it as much as I did. And yeah, definitely drop some suggestions below. You know, I mean, we have tons of tool suggestions. I'm definitely looking more for a Puscifer especially, but also a Perfect Circle, like specific songs that you guys want to hear. Because I'm just kind of like guessing in the dark now sometimes and just, you know, grabbing ones that are popular or whatever, which is fine. And I'll keep doing it because I want to hear it all. But definitely let me know if there's like specifics. But yeah, thank you guys so much. We love you guys. Can't wait to see you next Monday. See you then.